Hey YouTube, it's Tristan from Smart Home Point here. I recently got Hue lighting set up in a few places around my house. I then integrated it with Alexa. Now, overall, I found the integration really good, but there are some frustrating points to it. And the Hue skill on the Alexa platform currently has only 2.6 out of 5 stars. It only has 2.6 out of 5 stars, which isn't great. There are some missing features. So I want to film this video to explain 5 issues and bugs and missing features that I have found with Hue and Alexa integration. Let's take a look. When I first started with setting up the Hue app, I set up all my rooms with names like living room and hallway. But then if I look at the bulbs, I also set them up with names like living room and hallway and landing and bedroom, as you can see. And what that basically means is that the rooms and the bulbs have exactly the same name. So when you then go to the Alexa app and you import everything, as we see here, once it's all finished, we click on continue. And you can see that landing is listed twice, bedroom's listed twice, and it's also said 10 devices are discovered. And here you can see that there's a lot of duplicates, and that's because rooms and bulbs are actually imported as exactly the same thing in the Alexa app. So if we click on lights, you can see bedroom's there twice, landing's there twice, living room's there twice, and this creates issues, as we were about to see. Put on my bedroom light.
A few things share the name my bedroom light. Which one did you want?
Bedroom.
Okay.
Let's look at how we fix this. What I actually had to do was go into the Hue app and delete all my rooms, and I renamed my bulbs to things like near door E14 and master sleep area E14. In other words, things that I'm not going to say. And then I gave my rooms normal names such as hallway. What that meant was that I no longer had any duplicates. My rooms were called one thing and my bulbs were called something completely different. So then when you speak to your Echo device, there's no longer any duplicates. So those rooms are sensible names. In terms of fixing things, though, I had to delete everything out of my Alexa app. And to do this, I actually went on the web app instead. I'll put the link in the description. The best way of doing this is go to Smart Home and go to Devices. And as long as you haven't got many other devices set up, at the bottom, you can either forget all individually or you can click on forget all and delete them all. And that'll wipe your Alexa app. Then, now that things are sensibly named, you can go back to your Alexa app. You can re-import all your bulbs. It takes quite a while. It says 45 seconds. It can take a bit longer. But there you are. It's now discovered the correct number of bulbs and the correct number of devices. And what you see here is there's no longer any duplicates. Landing is only there once. Bedroom is only there once. And now everything's set up. But what this will mean is we no longer have duplicates. And hence, when we speak to our Echo device, we shouldn't have any issues. So there you are again, you can see that everything is only listed once. Let's get rid of that. So yeah, in lights, you can see bedroom is only listed once, living room is only listed once, hallway is only listed once. And then the bulb itself has a stupid name, which you're not likely to say, and that won't confuse your Echo device as a result. So now let's have a look at how this works. Alexa, turn the lights on in the bedroom.
Okay.
Alexa, turn the lights off in the bedroom.
Okay.
Please turn on my bedroom light.
A few things share the name my bedroom light. Which one did you want?
My bedroom light.
Okay.
Turn off bedroom light.
Okay.
Turn on bedroom light.
Okay.
Please turn off my bedroom light.
A few things share the name my bedroom light. Which one did you want?
Bedroom light.
Okay.
Right, so as you've seen, you have to be a bit careful with how you speak to your Echo device. I tend to find that if I use words like please and my, then Amazon's Alexa will get a little bit confused and think that you're talking about a duplicate bulb, even when you're not. So just be careful in how you speak to your Echo device. be a bit more direct and say things like turn on bedroom light or turn on landing light, instead of saying things like please turn on my bedroom light. As long as you're careful in how you speak to your Echo device and you use the correct direct words, it should work fine, as long as you haven't got any duplicate bulbs or duplicate room names, as we looked at in issue one. My third issue with the integration between Hue and Alexa is that in the Hue app, you've got routines down here, and you can do a variety of things. For example, you can say to wake up slowly, and this happens by your light in your bedroom slowly turning on, coming brighter and brighter to give you a natural sort of wake-up feeling. This really nice sort of feature of Hue bulbs. You can also have a very similar thing called going to sleep, which will slowly turn the lights off to slowly prepare your body for a good night's sleep. Now, the issue with that is if you set this up in the Hue app, although it works well, you can't then trigger these routines or manage these routines in your Alexa app. Why is it saying no internet connection? Routines. There we are. So if you wanted to take the routine that you've just set up here and build that into a routine from your Alexa app, you can't do that. So in other words, if you click up here, enter routine name, when this happens, if you go to smart home, you can't trigger it from Hue app, from your Hue bulbs, they just don't appear. The good thing with Alexa is you can trigger it from sometimes other things, such as a Ring camera or Ring doorbell. But in this case, you can't say trigger it based on a routine from your Hue app. What that means is you're a little bit limited, because if you create some more complex routines here, you can't end up building them into Alexa. And as a result, your integration isn't quite as good because you can't control everything through both. The solution to this is, instead of using the routines from your Hue app, as we looked at before, do as much as you possibly can in the Alexa app by going to the settings up here, clicking on routines on the left in the middle, and as we looked at before, clicking the plus button and creating a routine here. This is because Alexa is more of a smart hub. It'll have more devices connected to it. Obviously it won't just be a Hue bulbs, it'll be Ring cameras and all your Echo devices. So as a result of that, the routines you build can be a lot more all-encompassing than if you try and do things through the Hue app, where it's not going to be detecting as many devices. One caveat of this is Hue can import Zigbee-based devices, while most Echo devices cannot. Obviously the Echo Plus can, but all the other Echo devices can't. So if you've got a lot of Zigbee-based smart devices, then you are a little bit stuck. You either need to go out and buy the Echo Plus, which has a Zigbee chip, or you need to sort of have some routines set up in your Hue app and some set up in your Alexa app, which is then a little bit of a pain, but that will be a solution to this problem. My fourth concern with the integration between Hue and Alexa is that if we go into one of our light bulbs, this is a white ambience light bulb, and we go to the colour wheel, you've got quite a lot of different choice of colour. In fact, it's hundreds or even thousands of different choices available to you here. And obviously you can do sort of a warm yellow, you can do a cool white, or anything in between. That's a complete white, that's a very small yellow, that's a very small blue, etc. And you've got quite a lot of fine grain control here. And if you've got a colour Hue bulb, the situation's even better, where the colour picker you've got will enable you to choose up to 16 million different colours, which is obviously quite a lot of variety. My concern with the integration with Alexa is that you just don't have that level of choice. For example, if we go to devices down here, which I've just done, and then go to lights, if we go into the same light, which is the living room one, there, all I can really do is go down to colour here, set, and literally on white ambience, I've got five choices. That's it. I can choose warm white, soft white, daylight white, and cool white. Which, at least I can choose something, but it's not really ideal. And certainly if you've got a Hue colour bulb, then on the Alexa app, I think you've got a choice of 123 different colours that you can choose down here in the Alexa app, which again isn't great when the Hue app is actually giving you 16 million different colour choices. I don't know why the Alexa doesn't have a colour wheel, but right now it doesn't. One sort of solution to this is if you go back to devices, you can go into scenes, and in there, any scenes you've got set up on your Hue app, such as any of these, or any that you've created yourself, you can choose them here. So I could say I want Arctic Aura in the living room, and that will then play, or I could end up enabling that and choosing that for that particular light, and then that particular colour for that particular scene will play on my Hue bulb in my living room. And that does work well, but it's not exactly ideal because there's a lot of options here, which I'll look at in a second. That's another concern I've got. It's not really ideal. My fifth concern with the Alexa integration is that if we, in the Hue app, go into one of the bulbs, you've got a few options up here. If we click on the middle one, it takes us to the different scenes that are available to us. So for example, we have one called Savannah Sunset, and that's a particular type of colour, which is sort of a cool white. You got Arctic Aura, which is sort of a warmer blue. So you've got a few different options. Now, this is really cool, and you can say to your Echo device that you want to play a particular scene in a particular room, and that does work really well. But if you're trying to manage things in the Alexa app, things aren't quite as good. Because in devices, we've got the Scenes tab, and these get imported from the Hue app. And under Scenes, we've literally got an absolutely massive list. What we've literally got is for every single type of scene, whether it's Savannah Sunset or Spring Blossom or anything else, you've got one of those for every single room or for every single bulb you've imported. And as a result, you've got absolutely tons of these. Now, this isn't ideal because it's hard to actually keep track. There's no filter, there's no icon to search or to filter. It's literally just a gigantic list. And I've literally only got 4 white ambience bulbs set up and imported, and then a white bulb, which brings in, I think, 3 different scenes. So I haven't actually got that many scenes, but yeah, I've got this massive list already. Now, if I actually had 50 Hue bulbs, this list would be completely unmanageable. And unfortunately, if you're trying to create a routine in Alexa, unfortunately, the same thing is true. Blah, blah, blah. You don't get any filter even here. So we'll say add new. We'll go down to smart home. And we'll say we want to control the scene. And again, you've just got this absolutely massive list. At least, in this case, at least it's alphabetically sorted, which is at least positive. But even then, it's not grouped per bulb. So obviously you've got Arctic Aura for the living room up here. And then down here, you'll have other options for your living room. This is not even grouped per bulb. It's literally just a big list based on the scene name. And again, if you have a lot of Hue bulbs, this will become rapidly unmanageable compared to the Hue app, where all your scenes are in a single place for a single room. And as a result, it's a lot easier to sort of manage exactly what you want to do for a particular bulb. Hopefully this is something Alexa can improve in the future just by adding a filter or research mechanism. In terms of how to solve this problem, as you can probably guess, unfortunately right now there isn't a solution, and that's because when you're working on a routine, you've just got a big list of stuff, and equally under here, you've got a big list of stuff. Now, if obviously the whole point of a scene is that you choose a particular color. Now, if under the routines you were able to choose, if you're able to choose a particular color, then that would be great. But in this case, you can't. As per issue 4, you're just left with a handful of colours, in this case 5 on a white ambience bulb or 123 colours on a Hue colour bulb. And as a result of this, you can't even rely on choosing a colour in lieu of choosing a scene. So if you want to choose a particular scene, you have to unfortunately manage it via the unwielding list that we see here, which will keep growing in size and complexity for every new Hue bulb you add, unfortunately. Okay, right, that wraps up this video. I've covered 5 issues that I personally have with Hue and Alexa integration. If you have similar issues or further issues beyond the 5 that I spoke about, please let me know down in the comments. If you like this video, please click the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.